Today we're going to talk about the fan extender. What that is the ability to add controllable fans in addition to the two that you have here. Unfortunately, you're going to have to use the power port over here. So let me review a couple things real quick for the BigTreeTech SKR version 1.3. This is your direct power that's driven off of whatever power you're using here. In this case, you can only use 12 volts of power. So you have your positive pin or 12 volt pin here, and then you have your ground pin here. Then I'm also going to tell you about our steppers, because we're going to turn the fan on while using a stepper so that we can cool it. And so what I've done is I pre-prepped the jumpers for the y-axis, and as you can tell, there's three jumpers here, whereas these are in a different position. So if you need to know more, please watch my A4988 and DRV8825 configuration video for the steppers. But I'm going to show you how to quickly install this. So we're going to pick this up, and as you can see, the enable pin is here, and we know that the other enable pin is right here. So we're going to rotate it over and insert it right here. Then we're also going to connect our stepper motor to the y-axis. And then in order to configure this, I need to show you a little bit more about it. But what we'll do to pre-prep here is we're going to hook up the 12 volt cable that we're going to use to run it. So I'm going to do the positive side on the left, which is voltage, and grounds on the right. And we'll leave that off to the side. So here is the underside of the fan extender. As you can see, this row right here is signal pins. The row in the middle is the voltage pins, and the row at the end is the ground pins. Now keep in mind, for fan pin 2 for signal, it's this pin right here, and fan pin 1 is this signal pin. This is the top side of the fan extender, and I need to point out a couple of pins. This terminal pin right here is the ground pin. The one next to it is our 12 volt pin, and then we have our first fan being right here. So it's the positive terminal, and this is the negative terminal. Then our second fan is positive terminal, and then negative terminal. Okay, in order to wire this up, what we're gonna do is we're gonna use our end stop for the X max, which is located right next to the X minimum. This is the X max. And if you've watched my tutorials on end stops, you know that it says voltage, ground, and signal down here. So that corresponds to each one of these pins on the soul screen. So we're going to start with voltage. So I'm going to hook it up right here. It's the top pin for X max. And then what we're going to do is we're going to connect on the fan extender the voltage. So to make this simple, what we're going to do is we're going to connect over here. So voltage is actually in the center on this. So there we go. Next, we're going to do ground, which is the next pin down. And that's going to be the bottom pin right here. And then finally, we're going to do signal, which is the last pin in the X-max end stop. And that pin goes right at the edge right here, so that when we flip this over, the pins are aligned. So next, we need to connect the actual voltage we're going to run to it, and because the positive pin is over here, we're going to slide that on. And then finally, because the actual pin is on the opposite side, we're going to connect our fan extender for our one fan right over here. And the other fan we're going to leave out of this tutorial because we're not using it. So I'm just going to move that off to the side. Now, in order to load the firmware, what we need to do is connect the big side of the serial USB to the SKR version 1.3. And then we need to take the small side of the serial cable and connect it to the computer, and you're going to hear a beep. Okay, to start with, I'm going to talk about the end stop because we had the three pins of voltage, ground, and signal. So here's your voltage, your ground, and your signal. And so we know that it corresponds to pin 1.28 on our schematic over here for the pinouts. So next we're going to check on the USB drive because we need to see what state it's in. And currently the cursor file for firmware has the date of today. So keep that in mind. This will be relevant in a moment. And we're going to go over to Atom. And inside Atom, we have PlatformIO's plugin loaded. So if you need to load your version of Marlin-Bugfix-2.0.x, what you're going to do is you're going to go over to Open Folder, and on your unzipped copy from the Marlin website for 2.0.x, you're going to open that folder. But I have it open right now to speed things up. So the first thing that we need to do is we need to go over to the Marlin folder and open that up. And inside there's a source folder. Inside the source folder, we're going to go to core and we're going to open up boards.h. In boards.h, we're going to do a search on SKR. And the one that we're looking for is board_BigTree_SKR_V1_3. So we're going to copy that. And then we'll back out of these folders and we're going to go to configuration.h. And what we're going to do is do a search on motherboard. And we're going to replace board_ramps_14_EFB with what we just copied. So we're going to paste it here. And then we're going to scroll up. And for define serial port 0, we have to change the 0 to a -1, otherwise this won't work. And then we have to do a search on A4988, and we need to enable our steppers. So as you can see right here, there's a bunch of steppers. So we're going to remove the comment for X driver, for the Y driver, for the Z driver, and for E zero, or your first extruder. Now, if you have a different type of stepper driver, like a DRB8825, you can always copy it. And because we're not using X, I'm just going to show you that you can paste it here. But remember, you may have to make a modification if you have a different stepper, depending upon what you have. So in this case, for the DRB8825, we need to find, let's say, max_ to get us where we need to go. So for default access steps per unit, if it were the X driver for the DRB8825, it has twice the degree of step of the A4988. The A4988 has 1/16th of a step, whereas the DRB8825 has 1/32nd of a step. You would have to change it to 160, basically doubling the 80. So now that we have that set, we're going to go over to the configuration.h and we're going to do a search on use_. And what we want to do is we want to remove the comment for use_controller_fan. And we also want to remove the comment for define controller fan pin -1. And because it's negative 1, we have to remember what we just looked at a moment ago, which is right here for the pins. And the pin number is 1.28. So in order to add that, it's going to be P for pin, 1, and then underscore 2.8. And because I want to keep the tutorial short when I show you how to test it, I'm going to change the 60 to 5 seconds for the duration for the fan to turn off once the motors are disabled. So we're also going to change the fan speed to 200 because the max is 255, and I wanted to show you how to set it slightly slower. Remember, zero would be off. So we have that set. Now we have to set up the PlatformIO.ini, so we're going to click on that. And our chipset right now is for the ramps configuration with the Mega, ATmega 2560. Our chipset is not that for the SKR version 1.3, so we have to scroll down and find it. And so it's right here, it's the LPC 1768, so we're going to copy that. And remember, that's an ARM Cortex M3. So we're going to scroll back up, and for our default environment, we're going to change that by pasting it right here for the LPC 1768. So in order to compile this now, all we have to do is press the upload button, and this will compile the changes that we just made, and it will upload it to the board. So we're just going to click save and build. Okay, as you can see, firmware.cursor is still there, for CUR is actually the extension. But now we have firmware.bin. So note the time on that. So I'm going to remove the USB drive from the computer and then reconnect it. And as you can see now, it appears to have updated with the time. So we're going to go over to Atom to verify that we have an actual build done. So we're going to go to PlatformIO. And we're going to select toggle build panel. And as you can see, it says successful. Okay, off camera, I hooked up the power supply, as you can see. Now I'm going to plug it in. Now keep in mind, you want to keep your hands away from the board because there's live voltage. Okay, I'm in the Pronterface folder. I'm going to open up Pronterface. I'm going to connect to the SKR version 1.3. As you can see, it says connecting. Now it says printer is now online. So let's double check the firmware version by typing M115 and pressing enter. And as you can see, it says the firmware version is 2.0.x. So now I'm going to move the Y-axis 100 millimeters and see what happens with the fan. And as you can see, the fan activated when the stepper was activated. So now I'm going to press the motors off button and we'll see what happens with the fan. So if you like my tutorial, please press the like button and subscribe. And thank you for your time.